In today's video, we're going to take a look at some of the differences between a traditional scale and a scale that's designated as a checkweighing scale. Why would I choose maybe one versus the other, or go with that checkweigher? So the checkweigher has the ability to give you an indication as to whether or not your product that you're placing on the scale meets certain requirements of weight. Either you're over a specific target or you're under a specific target. And the checkweigher is going to give you some visual feedback as to whether or not you're within that particular range that you're looking for. Now, while somebody could do that with a standard scale and simply look at the weight on the display, the checkweigher and its visual feedback is going to help remove some of the guesswork out of it, help minimize the mistakes that might be made at the human side of things. But we want to give you a little bit of a demonstration here as to how some of these checkweighing applications work here, so that you can see by just plugging in a few numbers and setting a couple parameters, you can have a very quick and easy and efficient checkweighing application set up and running, as opposed to configuring some complex batch routines or something like that with a traditional scale. So as you can see, we've got a CW90X here with a bench scale. By default, the CW90X is set up in what we would call a range mode. And so what you're going to do is simply set an overvalue and an undervalue. Whatever falls within that window is going to be accepted. And so what you see at the top of the CW90X are lights for under, which would be red, accept, which would be green, and over, which would be yellow. And so what we're going to do here, you'll see on the left-hand side of the display, the overlay, we have an over and an under button. And so I'm going to start by pressing the over button. You see that the over lights begin to flash, because here I'm going to set the weight value for the over condition. And suppose I want to indicate that 5 pounds is okay, but I don't want to go over 5 pounds. I'm going to go ahead and set my value here for 5 pounds. I'm going to hit enter. And then I want to set my under condition. So maybe I want this to be between 3 and 5 pounds. I don't want something under 3, that would be too low. So I'll set my value here and press enter, and again. So now, and I want you to pay close attention to this. Notice that I set my values here for 3 and 5 pounds. These values are non-inclusive. So we're looking for a value that falls between 3 and 5 pounds, but does not include 3 and 5 pounds. And that's a common mistake that is sometimes made with checkweighing setups. So when I place 5 pounds on the scale, it's going to tell me that it's over. If I want to make sure that 5 pounds is included in my range, I want to bump my value one division higher so that exactly five falls within the accepted range. You can see if I just apply a slight amount of pressure to the underside of the base here, you see it pops into the accept range, but 5 is over. So what I can do is make a quick change to my over value. And let's say I move over and just simply say 5.1. And we'll hit enter a couple of times here. And now it shows that the 5 is accepted. But if I put more weight on, now I'm over. Likewise for the under value, the 3 pounds is non-inclusive. So if I put put 3 pounds on the scale, it's going to show under. So if I want 3 pounds to be included in my range, I would have to drop that under value to something a little less than 3. So perhaps I go in to my under value and I set this for 2.9 and hit enter a couple of times to get back out, and now 3 is accepted. So again, this is the default setup for the CW90X. This is the range feature where we're simply setting up a particular window under which the weights will be accepted.